Hi there. So I'm conducting this interview via email. I was sent the questions in an email, and then I'm going to be answering them myself, and I'm setting up the camera and everything on my own here. So I thought it would be kind of interesting to do this interview by answering each question in a different location. So I'm here in Yosemite National Park, so all of the questions will be answered in Yosemite National Park, but I'll go to a few different spots. In the background here is none other than Half Dome. Pretty amazing view of it here. I was a voracious reader and read all kinds of stuff, you know, Treasure Island and The Hobbit and Mark Twain, and remember, you know, reading about Huckleberry Finn floating down the Mississippi River on a raft and just thinking like, man, that is absolutely what I want to do with my life. So I went to, after I graduated from high school, you know, I was definitely starting to have some visions of traveling in my head, and I spent one semester at a community college up in Northern California, I just was not that into it at all. So after that, I moved back down to the Bay Area, lived with my dad for another few months, and I managed to come up with the money. Basically, I sold a computer, and then I found a job in an ice cream store. I bought a ticket to Europe, round trip ticket for like $600, and then my parents gave me a little extra money, and then my birthday rolled around, so it all added up so that I had enough to just barely for summer in Europe. And so the day after I turned 18, so this was May 1st, then I hopped on a plane to Europe, and that's how my travels began, and from there I just kind of kept on bumbling around. I would say Annapurna Base Camp trek was definitely one of the most astounding things that I've seen. I did that in 2008, and it was about a week-long trek, so it took about 4 days going up and three coming down, and that got up to about 13,400 feet, I believe. And so you're basically in the middle of a ring of mountains. Annapurna has several different peaks. There's obviously the peak, Annapurna 1, which is in the neighborhood of 24,000, 25,000 feet, I forget exactly. Then there's also like Annapurna 2, 3, 4, Machu Picchu, and I forget the others, but there's this whole ring of peaks, all of them over 20,000 feet, and you hike up into the middle of them. This was in March, and so it was after the winter snows. And so they were all completely covered in snow. There was snow on the base camp floor there, on the ground, and so it was just absolutely stunning. So a funny story that comes to mind was when I was traveling in India. This was my third time to India. I think I've been there four times altogether. So this was in like late 2007. I was actually going to the town of Rishikesh, which is a big yoga center, and it's famous for being where the Beatles went in 1968 and studied with the Maharishi. So I was in the town of Hardwar, and I was going to hike up a temple, hike up to this temple that looked down over the Ganges River, and I was hiking up this series of stairs that kind of winds up this hill, and I had a bag in my hand of this this like offering that you're supposed to give to the temple. I didn't even really want it, but you know, some old lady was selling them and just convinced me to buy them for 5 rupees, which is, you know, 15-20 cents. So I was carrying this in my hand, and this group of Indian men comes down the stairway, and they're like, you know, paved stairs, and they're trying to communicate something to me, and I'm not quite understanding, and finally they say, "Monkey, monkey," and they're pointing at my bag of stuff, and they're telling me, "You should put that away because monkeys are going to grab it." And literally 3 seconds later, this monkey reached up from behind me and snatched this thing. In 2009, then, I spent 4.5 months in the Mediterranean, I went to Greece, Egypt, and Turkey, and I spent 3 months in Greece. So I brought a mountain bike. Bringing a bicycle along is an amazing way to bring down transportation costs, obviously. You'll be saving on rental cars, taxis, buses, and it's a great way to get around, sort of depending on the terrain, obviously. I also did a lot of camping on that trip. I both stayed in regular paid campgrounds, and I also found some great spots to camp for free. So two islands in particular that I can think of where I spent about a week camping for free on those islands, and such an awesome way to go. So obviously I had my own tent with me, sleeping bag, sleeping pad and stuff, so you have to bring that stuff with you. But that's obviously an excellent way to bring down costs. Another obvious one, if you want to cut a hotel room in half, then bring a friend or a girlfriend or whoever. The other thing is to travel in off-season. So I arrived in August. The Greek tourist season starts winding down in September. So by mid-September, some things are starting to shut down, but there's still plenty open. Hotel rooms are coming down big time. We stayed on the island of Santorini, and we had our own room, awesome little room, for 30 euros, which would be about, 40, 45 bucks. So split that in two, you're paying like $20 basically for your own room on Santorini, in like the most popular village. So late September and October is a great time to go to Greece. It's still plenty warm, possibility of, storms and things, but you still get, the full experience, but less crowds and less cost. So that's something to look into. Wherever you're going is to consider going in off-season. Other than that, there are resources such as Woofing, which is a work exchange program. It's worldwide, WWOOF. Just search on Google because there's different sites for the different countries. And so you do work exchange either on farms or sometimes for individuals working on their land. You work, 25 hours a week or so, and you get free room and board. So that's a great way to, you're paying nothing at that point. You meet some local people. They might introduce you to some other people. You learn about some local hangouts. You could intersperse that with doing your own thing, and then you're at least bringing your costs down quite a bit some of the time, and then the rest of the time you're, free to do your own thing. Also, there's couchsurfing, couchsurfing.com or else couchsurfing.org, one or the other, which is both a great way to get a free night stay and also a good way to meet people. The other thing is to do other types of work exchange programs. When I was in Greece, then I did work exchange at a retreat center for 2 weeks. And they charged something for the first week. It was like either 100 bucks or it might have been 200 bucks for the first week. And that was just an initial payment. And then any time after that, even if I were to come back, the next summer or 5 years later, then I wouldn't pay anything. It would just be a straight work exchange for room and board deal. And so that was, basically 2 weeks in Greece for $200 is a great deal. As for other places I want to travel in the world, definitely a pretty long list. I was recently talking with some people about Central America, Honduras, Belize, Guatemala, and southern Mexico. Would love to visit that region. Mongolia is definitely on the list. I'd like to trek the Camino de Santiago in Spain. It starts in the Pyrenees and then goes along the top of Spain, and it's a pilgrimage route to St. John, St. Paul, St. Peter, some saint, but it's a pretty popular one, and it's supposed to be just spectacular. I'd also like to go to Iceland. I'd like to go back to Nepal. I'll definitely be going back to India. I'd like to go back to Greece. I'd like to go back to Egypt. I'd like to see other places in the Middle East, but at the moment things are pretty turbulent, so we'll have to see what political developments take place over the next 2 years. I'd also like to see more of Africa. I've just been to Egypt, but it would be cool to see, some places further south. There's certainly no shortage of other places to go. So, but for the time being, I'm just going to enjoy being here now in amazing Yosemite National Park.